you may be experiencing right now is called Sonder, the profound realization you have when you realize that every person around you has a life as complex and vivid as your own. In your own story, you are the main character, the protagonist, just like in a movie, surrounded by family, friends, and acquaintances. But every good movie has hundreds of extras in the background that really make the story what it is, much like how the random passerby that we see every day have influenced our story. But we often forget that they have stories of their own. So let's put ourselves in their shoes. Pretend that you are the random lady you passed last week walking her dog, or the guy that checked out your groceries at the store. What are they feeling? How do they perceive the world? Really try and put yourself in their shoes to understand their perspective. This is called empathy, truly trying to understand and feel other people's emotions. Hi, my name is Anna Lawson. Let's talk about our feelings. A lot of people don't really understand what empathy truly is. They might confuse it with sympathy, which is really just feeling sorry for somebody else's misfortune. But empathy is a little bit more complex than that. It's really trying to understand and feel other people's emotions and put yourself in their shoes. But what we often forget is that empathy is really actually hard. It's hard to distance yourself from your own emotions and put yourself in somebody else's shoes. But a lot of you might be thinking, well, Anna, I'm great at empathy. I cry all the time at sad movies. I'm super in touch with my emotions. So how is this relevant to me? But we actually aren't as empathetic as we think we are. Studies have shown that empathy is actually on the decline in America, but it's really not our own fault. A lot of this is due to uncontrollable and unconscious factors like emotional burnout, increased isolation, a rise in selfishness, and an unconscious empathy imbalance. So, let's take a look at the brain. Our empathy response starts in the anterior cingulate cortex, which is a tiny little part of the limbic system deep inside your brain. It alerts your brain when you see somebody in pain or in emotional distress. And this activates your empathy response. However, if this circuit is hit too frequently, we can experience emotional burnout, which we might not always recognize by ourselves. This might look like loss of motivation or distancing yourself from your loved ones, causing us to put up a wall to protect ourselves from this emotional overload. Helen Rice, who wrote The Empathy Effect, focused a lot of her studies on the empathy response in healthcare workers. She noticed that a lot of doctors are more prone to burnout, even though they are seen as some of the most empathetic individuals in society, which shows that really nobody is immune to burnout. In fact, a lot of us might be experiencing burnout right now. Because of COVID, everybody's emotions are so heightened, and it's hard for us to distance ourselves from our own emotions and really consider other people's feelings when our own emotions are so high. Constantly trying to share our emotions with other people can cause us to experience burnout. But a way to combat this is actually with compassion. Compassion has been found to strengthen resilience and strengthen connections with other people. Really just trying to be kind can have a huge effect on your empathy. It's an easy way to cheat burnout. You are treating people with kindness regardless of how you feel by yourself. Because so many of us have had to quarantine over the past year, a lot of us have missed out on these opportunities for empathy because it's harder to read social cues and make connections with mass conversations and Zoom. Family gatherings online and air hugs 6 feet apart really can't make up for this connection that we've missed. In fact, before quarantine even happened, there was already a decline in empathy. It was found that there was a 40% decline in empathy among young people over the past 40 years. But a lot of this is due to the increase in Americans living alone. This has really increased loneliness, which is a huge contributor to our decline in empathy. In fact, 25% of people were affected, 25% of people indicated that they felt that they didn't have somebody to talk to about important issues. And loneliness is a really unfortunate side effect of quarantine. But hey, at least we do have technology to keep us connected, right? Actually, no. Although technology has kept us connected through the pandemic and has kept the world running, it's actually become every good thing comes with a price. Technology and our phones have given us more of a choice for empathy. What I mean by this is that we can just click off of Instagram, turn off our phones whenever we see something emotionally distressing or is too hard to deal with, and we block this away and push down our emotions and don't address the situation, which can lead to destroying empathy. A lot of us tend to have selfish tendencies, and a lot of us tend to have selfish tendencies that we sometimes don't understand ourselves, and it can lead to a decline in empathy. A lot of us learned in world history that John Locke believed that humanity is inherently tolerant and reasonable, but we often gloss over the fact that he also believed that we had a tendency for selfishness. Selfishness has led to a huge decline in empathy, and it's a big barrier that we have to overcome in order to make these emotional connections and consider other people. In an article by Erica Weiss and Professor Jamil Zaki, it was found that sometimes the most empathetic people struggle with an empathy imbalance. These people tend to relate better and empathize more with their in-group, who are people that look, think, and act like themselves, and may have lower empathy for those who are more different from them, which is their out-group. If you think about who your friends are, it's more than likely that they are pretty similar, they have pretty similar physical characteristics to yourself, which is known as the matching theory in psychology, where you're more attracted to people that look similar to you or act like you. These people would be considered your in-group, the people that you spend the most time around and can relate to best, and the people that you don't spend as much time around or you have trouble relating to would be your out-group. In a lot of these people in this study were found to have greater empathy for their in-group, and sometimes had more negative attitudes toward their out-group, which was shown in a study by Emil Bruno. And he found that they often clung to the beliefs of their group instead of making their own opinions, even when their opinions were disproven, which is known as confirmation bias. In a study by Jeff Cohen, it was found that people were often more interested in which political party proposed a law than the actual content of the law. The best way to overcome this empathy imbalance is to distance ourselves from our in-group. Go outside of your comfort zone and try and relate better to your out-group. We've seen this a lot recently in politics, where conservative leaders condemned the Capitol riots led by radical supporters of President Trump, and Trump himself for inciting the riots. A lot of politicians have strayed from traditional party guidelines because they feel that their party has strayed from the morals and values that they originally represented. Researchers call this emotional compensation, where we change our feelings and our opinions when we feel that our group has gone emotionally awry. If we recognize these imbalances, we can improve our empathy and strengthen our connections with other people. All of us are victims of the empathy deficit in America. If you listen to anything I've said today, then listen to this. I want you to leave today with increased compassion, kindness, and love. Treat others the way that you want to be treated. You never know what's going on in somebody else's life. This doesn't just affect us. This affects the random lady you passed the other day walking her dog, or the guy that packed up your groceries. The empathy revolution affects every single person in this room. Without empathy, the world would be a much darker place. So let's bring some light into